In this video, I'm going to show you how to easily convert an SRT file to a VTT file and vice versa. Hi, my name is David from freelancerinsights.com, where we believe you should never stop learning. On screen are two files. To my left, or to the left of the screen, is a sample SRT file, which is a SubRip subtitle file, and to the right is a sample VTT file, which is a WebVTT file that stands for Web Video Text Track subtitle or caption file. These two files are identical but have some few differences. Just from looking at them, you can see that the SRT file has numbering, while the VTT file lacks the numbering available in SRTs. The WebVTT file has a title, while the SRT file doesn't have a title. Now, just taking a closer look, you'll notice that the SRT file has a comma separating the milliseconds in all the sections, while for the WebVTT, that is the VTT subtitle file, has a full stop. So those are just basic differences that you'll notice with a WebVTT. And although a WebVTT is a more recent subtitling and captioning format, it's easily editable using Notepad or text edit on the Mac. So those are some of just to point out some few differences. So what we need to do is convert the SRT file or the SubRip subtitle file to the WebVTT or VTT subtitle file. What we are going to use for this is an application called Subtitle Edit. So I'll just open my Subtitle Edit, and once it's open, the process is simple and fast. And the reason why you may need to do this is just maybe a client requires an SRT file, a VTT file, or just you hosting videos on different platforms. For example, Vimeo recommends VTT subtitle formats. So you'd rather just do your SRT file and then convert it for the clients. When you open your subtitle edit, it may be different, but the format will show as SubRip, or depending on what was your last job that you worked on. So I worked on a SubRip file, and all you need to do is just go to File, Open, and navigate to the folder with the file that you want to convert to VTT, that is the sample.srt. We just click on Open, and once it opens, you'll see it's there. And don't worry about this. This is just some issue with characters per second, which can easily be fixed by maybe modifying the characters per second you want, or maybe readjusting whatever you have. And if we look at the source view, this is the list view. It shows you the numberings, the start, the end, the duration, the text. As for the source view, it just shows you what we were looking at. If we go back, this is what we see from the SRT sample that you see. This is the source view. So basically, what we need here is just to convert this to a VTT. And all you need to do is just go to File, Save As, and it will, you'll have to select the folder where you want it saved, and then click on the drop down and just navigate down, scroll down slightly up to WebVTT. Here is WebVTT. I don't use this, but I'll use this. And then we can just rename it to updated sample.vtt and click on Save. Once we click on Save, the format changes here. And if we check out the source view, you'll see that the WebVTT title has come up. There is no numbering. And then we have the full stops in place of the commas to indicate the millisecond extension and all that. So if we look at our folder has the updated VTT. If you double click on it and minimize this, whatever we are seeing here is what is here. So you've just converted your SRT file to a VTT file in just a matter of like clicking a few buttons and saving. And we can still do the vice versa, that is go to File, save the VTT as an SRT, and just click here. And SubRip or the SRT file is usually number one. So you just come here, just click on it, and then we can call it updated sample.srt. So we can just click on Save, and the format changes, as you can see here. And the source view, if we go up a little bit, has changed. The WebVTT now is gone, since this is a new file. And also always try to ensure that you save with an encoding of Unicode UTF-8, which is supported by most applications. So we can check out the updated SRT file. And if we minimize, you'll notice that this is identical. So basically, that's how you can easily convert an SRT file to VTT or VTT to SRT in just a few clicks. If you're interested in learning how to caption and subtitle videos so that you can make money on the site, kindly check out my course from the link in the description below. And if you're not yet subscribed to the channel, kindly do so and turn on the notification bell icon so that you can be notified every time I release another tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, never stop learning.